I'm David Hansen, the editorial page editor of the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, and we're here this afternoon with Stephanie Klett, who is the department chairman for the Department of Tourism for the state of Wisconsin. Welcome.
It's nice to be here.
We were talking earlier during one of our editorial board meetings about the increase in the budget for the department this year. You went from, I think you said, $9.9 million last year in marketing to about $12.5 million. Now, this came amid cuts for other budgets, such as schools and local governments. I wonder if you could talk about why you thought that increase was needed.
You bet. $9.9 million for marketing sounds like a lot of money, and especially in the last year, schools were cut $900 million. Why should tourism get more? Mm-hmm. Well, right now, tourism is the third largest industry in Wisconsin behind manufacturing and agriculture. It's big business, $12.3 billion. So the first thing is that what we give back to the state of Wisconsin is $2 billion. $1.3 billion to our state government, and then over $600 million to municipalities, and that money is used for schools. So really, what you give us, we will get back. The other thing is we have to remain competitive. Last year, Illinois had a marketing budget of $48 million. Pure Michigan, $30 million. Wisconsin, $9.9 million. Now, if these folks vacation in Illinois or Michigan because they're getting the ads out and they don't come to Wisconsin, but they have a great time over in Michigan, they may never come to our state. Mm-hmm. You know, we will have lost that opportunity.
When you say give back the, I think $600 million was your number, what do you mean by that?
Revenue okay. for taxes.
Okay, and what are you seeing in the numbers so far? I don't know if you have statistics to show you how the campaign is going, but how are you measuring that?
Well, we have a research firm we use called Longwoods International. Mm-hmm. In fact, it's a new research firm with a better economic model. In fact, the most current, they say, and best economic model that exists in the world. Pure Michigan uses them. Hawaii, which has, an $80 million budget, they use them. So it's a tremendous model, and that's where we're getting our numbers from this point forward.
Mm-hmm. And so you'll have a report probably next year.
We will.
Current year numbers.
Next year, during National Tourism Month, which happens in May, we get the numbers. The numbers are finished about next February, and then it takes about a month or two to go through them with a fine-tooth comb, and they come out for National Tourism Week.
Okay, and talk a bit about the campaign. What's different about this campaign as opposed to previous ones?
Well, that's a great question, because over the last 15 years, Wisconsin has had five different slogans. Life so good, live like you mean it, escape to Wisconsin, you're among friends, stay a little bit longer. So we really had so many slogans, we no longer knew who we were. And so you think of New York and you think, I love New York. Well, we're sloganed out. So our campaign right now is based on solid travel research. And there are three top travel motivators. Number one is fun. Number two is rest and relaxation. Number three is to visit family and friends. So we have this campaign that's based on the theme of fun. It's not a slogan. And so it's something that everybody can relate to. And I tell you, so far, so good. The response has been terrific. And we were thrilled at the department when the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel gave us a laurels and not a lament over our new campaign.
Okay. Well, thanks very much, Stephanie. We appreciate you being with us.
You bet.